Thank you very much for accessing part 3 of the TPS65988X Application Customization GUI Tool video series. This video will walk you through how to configure your TPS65988X device for the DisplayPort Alternate Mode. Then it will move into how to use the GUI Debugging Mode, looking into how to change device settings, and reading and writing 4CC commands. DisplayPort is a USB PD alternate mode. In order to configure your TPS65988X device for DisplayPort, there are certain registers you will need to edit in the GUI. Register 51 will configure the DisplayPort settings, and register 5C will change the pin inputs and outputs that need to match the DisplayPort configuration. These register changes will be discussed in the following slides. Verify that register 47 has the modal operations supported bit set. The status registers that are helpful in debugging DisplayPort are the data status register, or register 5F, and the DisplayPort status register, or register 58. There are DisplayPort specific terms used by the GUI. DPF underscore D refers to a device that is the DisplayPort source. This is a device that will be sending the data for DisplayPort. UFP underscore D refers to a device that is a DisplayPort sync. This is a device that will be receiving the DisplayPort data. Register 51 is the DisplayPort capabilities register. The first two settings must be checked in order to enable DisplayPort for the device. The next setting is the port type. For this example, we are configuring the device to be a DFP underscore D. The third setting refers to whether the device is on a receptacle or a plug. The multifunction setting can be checked if you want to send USB data in addition to DisplayPort data. The second register that needs to be configured for DisplayPort is IOConfig, register 5C. This is the GPIO event mapping register. The only option that needs to be changed in this register is the mapped event setting. The mapped events have been changed to match a DFP underscore D device. GPIO events 0 through 2 are used to drive multiplexer devices, which will differentiate between the DisplayPort data and the USB data. For more information on DisplayPort and how to change the GUI to match a UFP underscore D configuration, please check out the DisplayPort Alternate Mode app note linked below. Next, we will be transitioning to discuss how to leverage the GUI debug mode. Before entering debug mode, the GUI needs the correct I2C addresses. Each resistor divider corresponds to two I2C addresses. These are displayed next to the address dropdown. Ensure that the resistor divider selected on the General Settings tab of the GUI matches the hardware. This ensures that the hardware I2C addresses match the I2C addresses that the GUI will try to use to enter debug mode. The GUI uses debug mode to read and write I2C information in real time. There are two different ways to use debug mode. Polling mode reads and writes I2C information continuously without further user prompting. The GUI defaults to polling mode when you enter debug mode. Manual mode can be entered if the polling button is pushed. The button will then display manual in order to indicate that the GUI is in manual mode. This mode allows you to initiate I2C communication. Once the GUI is in manual mode, each register displays three buttons: read, write, and clear. To switch back to polling mode, the manual button can be pushed. While debug mode can change the registers that you normally have access to, it can also change additional registers found under Debug Registers tab. These registers are useful for further debugging. A helpful debug register is mode, which indicates the operational state of the port. The device should display APP, which means the device is fully functioning in the application firmware. Next, I will demonstrate how to use manual debug mode to change configuration settings during runtime. When you click the Read button, the TPS65988X device will use I2C to read and list the sync capabilities currently being sent by the device, and the GUI will display Read Success. Using the Write button, I can update the sync capabilities. Here, I have changed the operating current from 900 milliamps to 1.5 amps and pressed Write. The GUI should then display Write Success. Debug mode also allows you to send 4CC commands. 4CC commands are 4-character commands that are sent to the host interface which in turn are used to communicate with the TPS65988X device. The commands can be sent using the execute button. Once they are executed, the GUI displays an output. More information on the unique address interface commands can be found in the device-specific host interface technical reference manual linked below. Thank you for watching this video in the GUI video series. Check out the other videos in this video series, talking about the basics of the GUI and how to configure PowerPass and change the source and sync PDOs.